What's up everybody, Andre from CBRN Academy here. Simple voice diaphragms, like this one, allow for your voice to be heard when you're wearing a gas mask. But what about the situation you find yourself in a noisy environment or your voice needs to be heard over a longer distance?
That's what voice projection units are for. In this video, we're going to compare three of them, so it's gonna be a lot of fun.
Specifically, we're going to test and compare voice projection units for C50, FM53 and General Service Respirator. Each gas mask uses its own system and we'll take a detailed look at each one of them, how they perform at different distances and what are their individual advantages but also downsides. We'll start off with the voice projection unit for the Avon C50 and FM50 gas masks. It consists of two parts, a voice projection unit and a microphone assembly. First, we need to insert the microphone. Flip the head harness over the front for better access to the 3-pin connector located on the inside of the facepiece. The VPU is powered by two AAA batteries, which need to be inserted into the device before use. We love the fact that you can easily unscrew the bolt securing the battery compartment cover, unlike other VPUs in this video. The correct way of how the batteries are to be inserted is depicted on the back of the VPU. When closing the compartment, be sure not to lose the sealing rubber ring placed on the inner side of the compartment cover. Once the battery compartment has been firmly closed, to attach the VPU, open the communications port trapdoor on the front module cover. Secure the VPU by the top two claws and then attach the electrical connections until the bottom claws click into place. So far so good, the preparation has been rather straightforward and intuitive. With the voice projection unit set, we turn it on with a toggle switch located on the left hand side of the device. Now, let the test begin.
So, this is how the C50 VPU sounds up close. The voice is not particularly clean and you can hear a lot of distortion.
But what's good is that you can actually hear me from a distance of a few meters.
At the distance of roughly 50 meters, the speech is barely audible due to heavy distortion, so even though this VPU is rather loud, your voice might get lost amid the noise the device produces. Another disadvantage of the Avon 50 series VPU we can mention is its size, since it sticks out a lot, which wouldn't be necessarily bad if not for the fact you need to be very careful about it while donning and doffing. The VPU is easily removed whenever needed without the need to take off the respirator, which is a big plus. To disconnect the VPU, squeeze the bottom claw clip to release it and tilt the device upwards. It's very practical and intuitive to use, but on the other hand, the voice quality tends to deteriorate the further you are from people you communicate with. Next stop, a rather rare VPU meant for use with GSR, FRR, GSRE and GSRE respirators. As you can see, it's a single piece of equipment without the need to install microphone and voice projection unit separately. Our first impression was, it feels quite plasticky with these soft and easy to bend edges, so you should be probably a bit more careful when using it. There is this rather big battery compartment underneath of which you have the speaker hidden behind the grid. There's a power button and power LED indicator on the left side, and according to the user manual, there should be a 3.5 microphone input on the right side, yet there is none to be found. We think the VPU was made in different variations, which were shipped with this universal user manual. What may come as rather unexpected to many is this inbuilt MRPS lever located right under the power button. MRPS stands for Modular Respiratory Protection System, and the lever allows for switching between positive and negative pressure mode depending on the exhalation chamber currently used with the respirator. This device is powered by three AAA batteries that need to be inserted into the battery compartment. However, the lid is secured by a bolt, and in order to open it, you need a Phillips screwdriver of the corresponding size. In our opinion, this is not the best design at all, especially in comparison with how easily the 50 series VPU compartment can be accessed without the need for any additional tools. The way batteries are inserted is pretty obvious and intuitive. Once the batteries are inserted, you need to secure the lid, and you'd better be very careful about the correct positioning of the bolt so you wouldn't destroy the thread while trying to screw it at the wrong angle. Also, good luck finding it if you accidentally drop it on the ground. To mount the VPU onto the respirator, we must first remove the so-called louvre cover that's firmly snapped onto the front of the respirator. That's another important difference compared to the Avon 50 series VPU. It can't be mounted and removed as easily, and certainly not while the respirator is worn. It is not easy to snap it onto the respirator because unless it is perfectly aligned, most times it will snap on askew, in which case you need to remove the VPU and try again. So far, the C50 FM50 VPU is considerably more foolproof when it comes to preparation and installation. But it surely looks badass once it has been installed. Upon turning the VPU on, it makes a rather loud beeping sound, and when the LED indicator turns green, the device is ready to be used. If the LED is flashing, the batteries are low and need to be replaced. Additionally, the VPU will emit a sound to indicate that the batteries are low, a very useful feature other VPUs in this video don't have. What's great about this VPU is the way it is integrated with the respirator so it doesn't stick out and cannot be easily or accidentally removed. To turn the VPU off, you need to press and hold the power button for 3 seconds. Speaking of batteries, in case you're wondering whether the big Rhino-style battery compartment doesn't obstruct the view, surprisingly, it doesn't. The VPU also includes an automatic power-off feature, which shuts down the power after 20 minutes of inactivity to preserve the battery life in case you forgot to turn the device off. Also very useful. Let's proceed to the test.
So this is how the GSR FRR VPU looks and sounds like. It seems the GSR FRR VPU is not as loud as the C50 one, but there is less distortion.
So this is how my voice sounds from a distance of approximately 25 meters. Not sure whether my voice is audible, and if it is, then reach into the
audible. The GSR FRR VPU is not as loud as the one we tested with the C50, but it produces a very clean voice with minimal distortion. This is especially useful at greater distances, since the voice can be heard much more clearly from 50 meters afar than with the C50 VPU. Even though it's not as user-friendly and definitely less foolproof in comparison with the Avon 50 series voice projection unit, this one comes with some very useful auxiliaries other devices in this video don't have, like the sound and the LED indicator or the automatic shutdown after 20 minutes. And now comes our third and last contestant. Voice projection unit for Avon FM53 and FM54 respirators. Before we start, you should know that there are two generations of this VPU system, but so far we were able to obtain only the first generation. Just as with the 50 series VPU, the kit consists of a microphone and a voice amplifier, and the microphone connects into the same 3-pin connector located on the inside of the facepiece. The voice amplifier is much sleeker than the C50 one, and it's powered by a single CR123A battery, which needs to be inserted in the battery compartment. Just keep in mind to close it as tightly as possible, ideally using a small coin. Now we just need to place the amplifier in front of the exhaling chamber and set its position by turning it clockwise until it clicks. The amplifier can be easily removed by pressing the release button and turning the device counterclockwise. Even though it's set, the amplifier needs to be connected to the microphone by plugging a cable into this connector located on the bottom of the facepiece. The amplifier has its own separate connecting slot that allows for connection of compatible comms. The VPU is turned on by a switch located on the front of the device, and of all three tested devices, this switch is the worst. Not a big deal, but unlike the intuitive and responsive C50 toggle switch, which can be easily turned on and off even with gloved hands, this switch is more difficult to operate as it is harder to locate and grab with your gloved hand, and it doesn't have the snappy switch. Here comes the test.
This is our third and last video contestant. The VPU for the FM53 and FM54 for Maven protection. There's a bit of distortion, but not as much as with the C50.
25 meters away from the camera, and this is how the FM53 performs. I hope my voice is audible. Let's see how it works.
The voice emitted from the FM53-54 VPU sounds clearer than the voice coming from the C50, but it's definitely nothing to write home about. it performs better, yet the voice quality is nowhere near the GSR FRR voice projection unit. We used this opportunity to swap and test the Avon microphones, since apart from color, they look exactly the same, even connector-wise. Yes, you can easily mount the C50 mic into the FM53 and vice versa, but surprise surprise, they are not cross-compatible. This is what happens when you attempt to use the 50 series microphone with Avon FM53-54.
So, this is how it malfunctions. You should not be using the C50 mic with the FM53 DPU. Unless you switch it into the positive pressure mode, at which point you actually are my voice can be actually heard without this debilitating distortion from my breathing. But it's not an ideal solution at all, and I should have had my PAPR device connected, or a CBA or whatever. So this is not the way it's supposed to be used with the filter. When we switch back to negative pressure mode, and here we go again. So yeah, C50 microphone is not compatible with the FM53, FM54 VPU, even though it works this way, but not the way it's supposed to be.
Based on this test, considering everything we mentioned, our personal number one is the GSR FRR VPU from Scott Safety. Even though it's not very user-friendly and it's rather complicated to prepare and mount, the voice coming out of the speaker is very clean and it actually sounds human. Not to mention more complex electronics inside, which allow for useful functions like battery indicator or automated shutdown to preserve batteries. Second place goes to the first generation FM53-54 VPU. It's easy to set and mount, and the voice quality is alright. Good for close and medium distance communications, but your voice gets mildly distorted over longer distances, such as the 50 meters range. Plus, the on-off switch is awful. Despite all the positives mentioned about the Avon 50 series VPU, it ends up on the last place simply because of its voice quality. The VPU is rather loud in comparison to the other two, which is not a bad thing, but your voice comes out distorted. Nevertheless, we consider it a good practical VPU, ideal for close distance communication, but it's an older piece of gear, long surpassed by more advanced technologies. As we didn't test the VPUs in a noisy environment, we can't say how well they perform in such scenario. But you can expect us to conduct more performance reviews in the next videos in much rougher and busier environments. Thanks for watching! We hope you liked this video, like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time in CBRN Academy.